Praise the Lord. It's
Amen. Great
to be with all of you together.
Yes.
And what a joy to, although we are in distance, thousands of miles away, but we can be together. We can worship together. We can praise God together. We can study scripture together. So let's just bow our head to the Lord in prayers. Lord, we thank you and praise you for this time. Lord, bless our time together. Anoint us afresh and help us, Lord, to glorify your name. Whatever we read, whatever we speak, and whatever we hear, all for your glory. For we pray in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Praise God. What a joy to be a Christian. What a joy to be a believer. What a joy to know him. And all glory to God alone. Mm-hmm. And since we don't have any part in the salvation, in forgiveness, and it's all glory goes to God. We don't boast in anything. Sometimes we say, you know, at least I believed in him. But even Ephesians says that even the faith you have is the gift of God. So don't say, you know, because you made put some effort. Sometimes people say, well, I had to take baptism to get saved. Well, I don't believe Christ plus baptism is equal salvation. It is Christ alone who had saved us. His cross is sufficient. His sacrifice is sufficient. But what a joy to know the Lord. What a joy to be assured of forgiveness, salvation. It's a great joy to be saved. And even time like now, when everybody is panic and people don't know what is going to happen, uncertainty, because our relationship with God is restored, because we belong to him, and today we can be... We cannot behave like others are behaving. We cannot think like others think, because we know our Savior.
Amen.
And even we can face today. Amen. So, since Christ has saved us, we have been saved by grace alone, by faith alone, by Christ alone. And so, all glory we give to him. Now, that is why the first thing, let us read the Galatians chapter 1 and verse 10.
For do I now persuade men or God? Or do I seek to please men? For if I still please men, I would not be a bondservant of Christ.
Amen. Yeah. See, we are bond servant of Christ. We are not servant or slave to anyone. And so, what is our job? Since we have been forgiven, we have been saved, we have been restored, now the only one thing I need to do, we need to do, to please him. We are not pleaser of people. Even we live in the world today when manipulators are so many. They love manipulating, you know, they love, doesn't matter what kind of life you live, people want to be praised, and you know, and people today manipulating everything. No, we are not manipulator. We are here to preach the truth. We are here to live the truth, to practice the truth, and to glorify Christ alone. Yeah. We are only here to please the Lord. Ephesians 5:10 says, don't read it, 5:10 says, find out what is pleasing to the Lord. Know what is pleasing to the Lord. Beloved, this is the time. This is the time to evaluate our own life. This is the time to check our motive. Why are we living? Is it here? I live my life to please the Lord? We got to evaluate. We got to examine our life. That's why plenty of time we have been given, you know. Lord gave us lockdown, and then you just sit down at home. Don't say I don't have time. You have plenty of time, you know. And so, as I always say, two things can happen in this lockdown time. Either you can become bitter or you can become better. So either you can complain, oh, what has happened? I lost my job and I'm sitting at home and I'm not getting to eat what I wanted to eat. And well, or you can say, thank God, I'm sitting here. I can have plenty of time of reading the scripture. I can sing, I can praise, I can dance, I can do anything I want. So beloved, this is the time, it's a blessed time, because I believe God allowed this COVID-19. He allowed it. If he wanted, he could have stopped in Wuhan, right there in China, but he allowed it. He did not stop. And he did not start it, but he did not stop. And so there is a purpose in it. I don't know what is the purpose behind, but as Romans 8:28 says, all things work together for good for those who love him. So I know there is something good in it. I don't know what, but only when I go up, I'll ask him, what was good in it, Lord? And surely we will look back after some time and we'll say, thank God for the time we had. So beloved, we are not here to please people. Don't spend your time pleasing people. You will not be able to please in the world. Somebody will be angry with you. Somebody will be upset with you. Somebody will be, you know, not pleasing to you. So only one motive, and motive is to please the Lord. And that's why we got to evaluate our own life. Am I pleasing the Lord? Is my behavior, we can just perform things. Do you get it? Sometimes we sing as a routine. Okay, let us sing this song. Let us stand and sing together. It could be just a routine without coming from inside. Yes. So we got to evaluate. We got to check our own life. Why I'm singing? Why I'm preaching? Why I'm praising? Why I'm reading Bible? We got to check. We got to evaluate that. And because this is the time God has given us. Praise God for the time. And so do not leave for the approval of others. What others are going to say. Sometimes, you know, we think, oh, what people will say. I don't need approval of people. I know I'm saved. As with the natural, so it is spiritual. If somebody asked us, are you born in this world? What would be our answer? I think so. No, I won't say. I will say, of course I was born in this world 60 years ago, 61 years ago. I was born. I know it. So as we are sure of being born in this world, this would be 100% sure, born in the kingdom of God. Amen. We should know we have been born in the kingdom of God. We know our sins are forgiven. We know it, that our relationship with God has been restored. I know it. Beloved, all of us, we got to know it. And so, since we know it, that everything what we have today is only through grace. Abundant grace. So what we got to do? We are living to please the Lord. Please the Lord. It doesn't mean to hurt people. It doesn't mean that I want to unplease people. But anyway, Jesus said people will not be happy. You know, sometimes people say, oh, come to Jesus, everything will be wonderful. I don't read that in Bible. He never said, come to Jesus, follow me and everything will be goody-goody. He never said that. He said, follow me and the trouble will start. The problem will start. And in Luke 9:23, he said, if anybody wants to follow me. He doesn't say when. If anybody decides to follow me, let him deny himself, take up the cross and follow me. Trouble will be there. Problem will be there. Sickness will be there. One good news is that Jesus will also be there with you, with us. Amen. So, beloved, we are to live to just to please the Lord, nothing else. Turn to second Galatians, second chapter, and chapter 2 and verse 20.
I have been crucified with Christ. It is no longer I who live, but Christ lives in me. And the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by faith in the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me.
Amen. Amen. So you are not defined by your past. This is what we see here. You're not defined by your past. What I was. Yes, okay, I was a sinner. I was anything, but today I'm different. I'm saved. That's why I said in the first one, we are not defined by our past. Today, see, I don't like sometimes Christians I've seen praying in the church, Lord, I'm donkey. Lord, I'm foolish. I'm useless. I'm nothing. God says, I know that. And I believe you. But then God says, now you believe me. Because you have accepted my Son as your Lord and Savior. You have repented from your sin. Now you have become royal priest, chosen people, holy nation, people belonging to God. Yes. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. 2 Peter 2:9, it says you are royal priest, chosen people, holy nation, people belonging to God. And you know what is the response? Our response is, no, Lord, not royal priest. I'm just humble servant of God. This is not humility. This is the rebellion against God. When God is saying, I don't remember your past, I'm saying, I'm not defining you by what you were before. Now you have become royal priest. Beloved, we must speak to ourselves when the whole world is after us to say Christians are bad, their character is, you know, this, and they are living like this. Oh, I know your life. I know your family. All right. But you don't know that there is a Christ who died for me and he has forgiven my sin. I'm a new creation. I know it. And so look at alone, stand before them in front of the mirror and encourage yourself. The whole world is ready to discourage us. We got to encourage ourselves. I'm not an ordinary person. I belong to the Lord. I'm a royal priest. I'm chosen person. I'm not an ordinary person. Beloved, we must speak to ourselves first. Problem is, we listen to the lie of Satan. Okay? So, we got to encourage. We must learn and we are not defined by our past. It's not what I was, what I am. That we got to remember. And so he says, now, chapter 3, verse 27.
Okay. For as many of you as were baptized into Christ have put on Christ.
Amen. Amen. That means, when we are in Christ, whatever we have put on, we have been put on Christ, and so only Christ has to be seen in our life. Because I'm covered with Christ. I'm completely covered by his grace, by his love, by his holiness, by his everything. So we sing that song, remember? Let the beauty of Jesus be seen in me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let the beauty of Jesus be seen in me. Not my beauty. Let the love of Jesus be seen in me. Let the humility of Jesus be seen in me. Let the purity of Jesus be seen in me. See, let Jesus be seen in me. All those who have accepted Christ, those who have been baptized in Christ, what happened? They have put on Christ. Again, evaluate our life. Is Christ seen in me in the marketplace? Is Christ seen in me in the school? Is Christ seen in me in the hospital? Or only Christ, I'm trying to show Christ in the church? That is what is happening. Today when they go to the church, they are like, holiest art thou. Oh, they talk very slowly in musical tone. Hello, praise the Lord. No, beloved, we cannot be, we cannot make up things. Be natural. Be natural, even in the church. Let Christ be seen in me. And that's why he says, you are the living epistles of Christ. Let people read us. Enough they have read Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Now world is waiting to, and they want to read us. Let Christ be seen. And that is the time God has given us, this time to evaluate our own life. Is Christ seen in me? This is the time, difficult time. And this is the time, beloved, this is time to just evaluate our own life, how close we have come to the Lord. Is Christ seen in me? See, this is something today, world accuses us. And Bible says, because of you, my name is being blasphemed among the Gentiles. Because we don't leave what we preach. We have many preachers, very few practitioners. Many professors to be Christian, but very few practice Christianity. We should be practitioners. And that again, one word, evaluate. That is why time has been given to us. This COVID-19 will help us too. And why? What is the purpose in evaluating? So we can correct ourselves, come closer to the Lord, come closer to the Lord, and we can say, yes, let the beauty of Jesus be seen in me. Let Christ be seen in me. That's the only purpose, because he has saved us. We are his, and we have no choice to do what we want. Today, people don't want correction. People don't want to be corrected. He said, this is none of your business. This is my life, your life. It's not your life. This life belongs to the Lord. He had died for us. It's his. We are his slave, bounded slave, Paul says in Galatians. So, beloved, we got to evaluate, examine our life today. And so what it says again in chapter 4. Turn to chapter 4, verse 7.
For you are no longer a slave, but a son. And if a son, then an heir of God through Christ.
Hallelujah. Amen. Well, we are no longer slave. What a joy. We have not experienced slavery. Remember what Israelites went through. It's a worse thing to become a slave. We were a slave of sin. Whole world slave. Praise God, we have been delivered. And no more be a slave, be a sons. Heirs. See, Jesus said, you know, in John, he says, no longer even I call you servant. No longer I call you servant. I call you my friend. Hallelujah. See, beloved, we got to know who we are. We got to encourage ourselves. Satan has been speaking too many lies in our life, discouraged us. And so people are saying, oh, this life doesn't worth living. It's worth living because Christ lives in me. We have the life of Christ, life of God in me, joy of God in me, and joy of Christ in me, humility of Christ in me, holiness of Christ in me. It's worth living. And so what happens? He says, you are no longer slave. Don't have the slave mentality. Have a son's mentality.
Amen.
You are sons and daughters. Sons. He says, you are my friend. See, again, I say, performing. I've seen people singing, what a friend we have in Jesus. But only in the church. Do we behave like one? Do we behave like friend of Jesus? Do we regard? Do we live their life like I'm a friend? If somebody is a friend of prime minister, even friend of queen, what happens? They would behave differently. How about me and you? We got to evaluate again. Am I behaving Because you know why he says you are my friend? Because he said servant doesn't know what master is planning, what master is thinking for each his plan. But friends know. That's why he made us his friend, that we should know the plan of God.
Yeah.
Beloved, we got to again evaluate, examine our life, come closer, become his friend, behave like friends. And so you can say, my friend Jesus, you can depend upon me. Share your plan. I want to be in your plan. Praise God. Beloved, we are not Humpty Dumpty's people here. We are here in the plan of God. Amen. We are in the plan of God. And so let us evaluate. Do I behave like a friend? You are a friend of God. And then when you know it, when you start living like a friend of Jesus, and then when you sing, what a friend we have in Jesus, it will mean something.
Amen.
Behave like friend of Jesus. So you're no longer slave. We are not slave of anyone. I was slave of sin, Satan. But now I'm slave or servant or friend of God, friend of Christ alone. Amen. I don't want to be a slave of anyone. Lord, remove anything. Sometimes people have become slave of money. People have become slave of popularity. People have propagating themselves. They want to exalt themselves. Oh, today, so sad. We are not here to propagate myself, but Christ alone. My Savior alone. And beloved, that when that starts happening, when we start living for him alone, only propagating him, then God is glorified. And we experience the joy I have in my life. Oh, my Savior was happy with my life. My friend is happy with my life. Friend, we are friends. We are no longer slaves. They're not slave. And if I'm a slave of Christ, is out of love. Not because he forces me. No, out of love I serve him. Out of love I'm ready to die for him. I'm not afraid of death. I'm not afraid. Many times I have been attacked. Many, many times. But I'm not afraid. Because I know for me to live is Christ, to die is gain. I'm not afraid. I know the departure date is booked. When I came into the world, Lord booked my return date ticket also. Only thing he never told me when I'm going to return. For that, I'm thankful to God.
Amen.
I'm ready. I'm not. No. See, it's not how long you live, for whom you live. That's what it matters.
Mm.
Amen?
Amen.
Amen. We are going to be a little quick now. Chapter 5. 5:25.
If we live in the Spirit, let us also walk in the Spirit.
Hey,
yes.
All those who are led by the Spirit of God are the sons of God. Romans 8:14 says, those who are led by the Spirit of God. We are not led by the flesh. When today, to this world, it's my life. No, it's not your life. You can't do what you want. Sometimes people think they are in position, they have money, they have resources, they can do what you can't do that. Beloved, we are led by the Spirit of God. And that's why we need to go every day on our knees and say, Holy Spirit, lead me. Holy Spirit, guide me. It's very easy for us to start walking in the flesh when we see the world today. But we have also seen the world, all the superpower, duper power, they all were paralyzed when the COVID-19 came. They never thought they would be like this. Oh, we have all the equipment, we can destroy the world. But they were scared of a small virus, which you can't even see. Coronavirus, can't even see and paralyze the whole world. Never, nobody thought about it. But when we are led by the Spirit, we understand, we think, we see things spiritually. Our Lord is in control. Our Lord, always I say, when people say, what will happen, Pastor? I tell them, our Lord reigns. Our Lord reigns. Amen. Amen. Okay. So don't be led by the feeling or emotion. You see what he's saying, but led by the Spirit of God. Don't be led by the feeling or emotion. Feelings will come and go. Emotion will come and go. But we got to build up our life upon the promises of God. Somebody said, don't build your life upon the blessings of God. Upon the promises of God. Because every promise is yes and amen. Amen. Okay. One more scripture before I close. Galatians 6:9.
And let us not grow weary while doing good. For in due season we shall reap if we do not lose heart.
Amen. Don't lose your heart. Don't lose our heart, beloved. You know, because we know, keep doing what God has told us to do. Keep doing good. And the best good thing is to share the gospel, preach the gospel. Wherever you find time, wherever you find the opportunity, pray in the morning, Lord, give me opportunity to share the gospel with one person. Share the hope, message of salvation to one person, for that Christ has died. So beloved, keep doing good. See, when I say good, many people think by feeding people, feeding poor, you shall be saved. No. Doing good is the lifestyle of a Christian, a believer. We do good, but not to get salvation. Because we are saved, we do good things. We serve people, not to get saved. So as we have our life. Yes. This life is a precious life. It's the life is passing now. It's not going to be for eternity. But it's a promised life. Amen. One who has called us, he has saved us, is faithful to keep us. Amen. He will keep us till end. So we got to evaluate our life for whom I am living. Keep doing good, because we will reap the harvest. Amen. Yes, what we do, what you sow, you will reap. Whatever we are sowing, we will reap. Let us again examine our life. What I am sowing today. Amen. Time is coming. It's a difficult time for believers. It's not going to be easy. People are not going to praise you for things. Today, people are afraid, scared. What people will say? I don't care what people will say. I'm here to please my Savior. I don't care. See, thing is, people have stopped preaching the truth today. But as we know, only truth sets people free. Not my good doctrine, not my philosophy, not my good story. It is the word of God alone. The power of the gospel transforms people. Nothing else can change this world. And that's why I always say, sometimes people say, oh, this is Christian country. See how they are living. That is Christian country. There is no Christian country in this world. But there are Christians in every country. Amen. So we are nation within the nations. We are different. I'm sitting here. You are sitting there. And we are both brothers, born in different culture, different language, and different upbringing. But we have one Father. We have one family together. Beloved, let us evaluate our life together. Come closer to Him. Know Him better. Serve Him better. And let this become our song. The greatest thing in all my life is loving You. The greatest thing in all my life is knowing You. I want to love You, Lord. I want to serve You, Lord. The greatest thing in all my life is loving You. God bless you, and may God keep you till His return. Amen. Keep you faithful till end. Bless you. Thank you.